Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and today I have the absolute pleasure to be at Marshall HQ in Milton Keynes. If you haven't already, check out the video of me going around at the Marshall Museum. Some amazing amplifiers, some rare amps, some vintage amps, some very peculiar amps, and some amps that don't even say Marshall on them, but they are still Marshall amps. Click the link in the description box to watch that video. But right now, I'm in the factory, where if you have a Marshall amp and it says Made in England on it, it came from this room. And what a place. It's like Neverland for me. This thing is so cool. Let's start here. This is where your Marshall amps start. So this lamp right here, it alternates. Depending on what amp they're building that week, it could be a Studio Vintage, it could be a JVM. So on a weekly basis, these guys alternate between different amplifiers. And you can see all the circuit boards and stuff right here. Absolutely crackers. Moving down the way. A really cool piece of kit. So some Marshalls are hand-wired, some of them are sold a little bit quicker, but all still made in the UK. It just bumps up production because everyone wants a Marshall amp, don't they? So you want it fast and you want it good. This machine is the wave soldering machine. So circuit boards come up, all the components have been placed on by hand on the circuit board, and it's simply just soldered in one fell swoop. Solders through here, goes on a little fan to cool down, and by the time it's down there, it's ready to handle. But when it's down there, it gets tested. Within a minute, they test every single component on that circuit board to make sure if it's perfect. If it's not perfect, straight back to the front of the queue. Let's go down and see these circuit boards before they get soldered. Right here, these are the amps that aren't hand-wired, but everything you see on that right there, that's a Studio Vintage, I believe, has been placed there by hand by real-life people. There's no robots, there's no nothing like that. It's Marshall. Everything made in England is done by hand. It's just quick and solder with that big machine there. Big terrifying machines which have lots of little components on which make our lovely amps sound fantastic. So that's where the heart of your Marshall amp is created. For the hand wires, this is the production line for the hand wired amps. They're cleaning up now because it's the end of the day, because I'll be filming that museum all day upstairs. This is where the point-to-point blues breakers and all the beautiful hand-wired stuff. Check out inside of there. There's a beautiful hand-wired point-to-point amp in there. So the hand-wired amps, exactly the same way as Jim was knocking them out in the 60s and the 70s. They're just things to behold. To play them, it's something very, very special. And as you can see, hand-wired by real people in Milton Keynes, where Marshall has always been based. Fun story. Jim Marshall bought this place in the late 70s. It was originally just up the road. It started out as the one warehouse. He then bought the warehouse across the road to expand, because Marshall is obviously Marshall, the biggest amp company in the world. And there was a road in between the two warehouses. What Jim decided to do was just close that road, let's put a roof over it and make one massive warehouse. I'll show you that road shortly. So this is finishing for the hand-wired amps and the rest of them. This is the testing zone. Every single amplifier that you've seen in this room, if there's an issue, it will come to the testing room right here, whether it be a pot not turning as fast or a bit slower than the rest of the pots. Even if there's a slight mark on the back, they're all checked out in this room right here. The attention to detail is just second to none. It's Marshall, for crying out loud. They have this brand to upkeep, so everything leaving this factory has to be absolutely perfect. Let's head next door to finishing. This is where you finally get to see the hearts go into the bodies themselves. So all the circuit boards you saw there went to the first line you saw, and they're crafted into the chassis. All the chassis are made in-house as well. In the warehouse around the back, there's a huge machine cutting out these chassis. All shapes and sizes for everything made in England, Marshall. The leaf here. And as you can see, lots of lovely ladies and gents putting these chassis into the iconic black and gold Marshall box of awesomeness. JVMs, 800s, the Studio Series. And at the back, you can see the cabs getting made and sprayed. Now the glue changed in the 90s to be more environmentally friendly. So the glue itself is sprayed on and then heated up to become sticky and adhesive. So I think they can, with 3 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes, Tolex an entire cab. But because it's that heat activated glue, say if any Tolex comes off your Marshall head or cab, heat it up with a hairdryer and that'll reactivate the glue and then press it back on. Obviously if you've got an old 70s one, it looks cooler the more destroyed it is, but if you want your modern Marshall head to look nice and perfect again, heat up with a hairdryer and press down that Tolex. It's also, as you can see, where all the cabs are finished, let alone painted, so all the Celestians go into the cabs, and you're gonna see the handmade nature of these Marshall products. They're not stamped out of a big factory. It's all put together by hand by real people who genuinely care about the brand. Everyone I spoke to today is a musician, or dad is a musician, or friend is a musician. Everyone here loves the brand and what they're doing. It's awesome. So now once these are all sorted, they go through a testing, which is really cool. Check this out. So once everything's put together, as you can see, there's a conveyor belt down there. They travel along here, all the way to the end. This is a little view into the that first production line as well. Very, very cool. So when they're finished, they get put on here, and then finished off, as it were. Come along here, the production line. To the right, you can see where the rivet and finish off the chassis. It's a very small operation. For the biggest amp brand in the world, you'd expect a massive multiple barns, but it's actually quite a small operation. It's really cool. So head through here. I think I've said it's really cool 400 times, but it's really cool. So this right now is that road I was telling you about before. So this was originally the road between the two warehouses, and on the right is that second warehouse that Jim bought. We'll say I'm not allowed in the wood store where they show where the cabs and the heads are actually made, because there's big saws in there and I haven't got a hard hat or any gloves. And I don't want to put any dungarees on. That room there, that single room there, is where the conveyor belt ends. Well, it doesn't end, but that's where it ends from that production line. Every single Made in England Marshall is tested in that room. Every single one. A couple of notes are played. Everything, if everything's good, it continues on to packing. Let's check it out. So this is the second warehouse, because why not? Everything comes through the conveyor belt right here. You're probably familiar with these. If you buy a Marshall amp, you will see the sides being protected by these. The doors are shut now because it's the end of the day, but the conveyor belt comes through here. It's scanned, so the staff know what kind of amp it is, whether it's a head, whether it's a cab, whether it's hand wired, and then it's packed up accordingly at the end. Some places it's shrink wrapped, but some places it's not because of different guidelines and stuff. Sometimes it's on wooden pallets, sometimes it's on plastic pallets. And you see lots of stock behind me. Loads of amazing Marshall stock. Everything here is sold, ready to ship out. It just shows how smooth of an operation this entire thing is, and a lot smaller than what you expect. So that's it, a quick whistle stop tour of your Made in England Marshall from start to finish, from the circuit board, from those first little hand-wired solders, all the way through to getting packed up to get delivered all the way around the globe. You can do this tour as well. Get yourself to Marshall headquarters in Milton Keynes, check out the factory, check out the amazing museum, and click the link in the description box down below to check out all the amazing Marshall products at pmtonline.co.uk. Right, that was a lot of fun. I'm gonna go plug one of them in now and have the time of my life. See you later.